This video will show you how to customize a sample file on the AutoChem 2 Microactive software. Remember to always consult your operator's manual for more detailed information. When you open up a new sample file or a sample file that has not collected any data, the SMP file will display the tabbed File Editor. Under the Sample Description tab, enter the description, such as name, operator, masses, and comments. For a pulse chemisorption analysis, click on Active Metals to specify the percent of sample mass of a metal. This can be edited before or after analysis. With the metal of interest selected, click on Adsorptive to specify the stoichiometry factor. Replace All is a useful feature that allows you to copy the parameters of an existing sample file to the current sample file. Under the Analysis Conditions tab, click on Insert Experiment for a sample run. Enter the description of your experiment and choose the type of analysis. Note the stoichiometry factor for a pulse chemisorption can also be edited here. Click on Zones to customize temperatures. These fields do not require editing. When the vapor generator is in use, set the vapor generator at 110 degrees Celsius and enter the reflux and flask temperatures appropriately. Click OK to save. Click on Gas Flows. Choose which gas flow to flow at the start of an experiment. Prep gas is used to prep the sample before analyzing and leaves the system without flowing through the TCD detector. Ensure the analysis valve is set to Prepare to flow the prep gas through the sample. This is a useful feature to oxidize, reduce, or degas the sample without posing potential damage to the detector. Please note, if the analysis valve is set to Analyze, the prep gas will bypass the sample even if a flow rate is entered. Ensure to select Prepare. Carrier and reference gas is the gas flowing through the TCD detector. Ensure the analysis valve is set to Analyze to flow carrier and reference gas through the sample. We recommend flowing an inert carrier gas at all times when the filament is enabled or if the mass spectrometer connected to the instrument has the filament on, waiting for trigger. Please note, if the analysis valve is set to Prepare, the carrier gas will bypass the sample even if a flow rate is entered. Ensure to select Analyze. The gas flow path of the carrier and reference gas goes through the cold trap valve after passing through the analysis valve. Set the cold trap valve to Trap to let the gas flow through the cold trap loop. When using this feature, ensure to submerge the cold trap loop in a cold trap bath to freeze out any undesired byproduct from a reaction before the carrier gas reaches the detector. For more information on the cold trap, please refer to How to Run a Temperature Programmed Reduction with Silver Oxide Reference on the Micromeritics AutoChem 2 video. Loop gas is used for a pulse chemisorption. Setting the loop valve to Fill and selecting a gas will fill the loop for dosing. When using the vapor generator, select an inert gas like helium as the loop gas and set the vapor valve to Vapor. Otherwise, set it to Bypass. Click OK to save. Click on Outputs. Check any outputs as needed. Typically, Digital Output 1, or DO1, is checked to trigger the mass spectrometer to start collecting data. Click OK to save. Click on Peaks. These fields usually do not require editing, but provide the option to edit the automatic peak detection and integration parameters. Click OK to save. Under Recording Options, check Include Input Signal if you wish to collect any extra signals. For example, selecting the reflux zone on the drop-down box will collect the temperature of the reflux zone throughout the experiment. Click OK to save. Click on Insert again More options will display after the experiment step is inserted. Change gas flow, change temperature zones, change valve, and set output are previously seen under the experiment step. These steps can be inserted to make changes throughout the experiment. Insert dose to make a loop gas injection, manual injection, or injection for a single point BET measurement. There are different options available to determine how long to wait after each injection. Insert experiment to perform several experiments consecutively. Gas calibration is used for TCD gas calibration. Please refer to How to Run a TCD Calibration on the AutoChem 2 video for more information. Loop calibration is used to calibrate the volume of the loop. Please refer to How to Run a Loop Calibration on the AutoChem 2 for more information. Insert the start recording step. Typically, we recommend to use one measurement every 1 second for temperature programmed analyses and 0.1 second for pulse chemisorption. Inserting start recording step will insert stop recording step automatically. Insert the start repeat step. This step is used for pulse chemisorption to repeat the dosing until the sample is saturated with an adsorptive. There are options to repeat until peaks are equal or set the maximum number of doses. For a reverse pulse chemisorption, select repeat until peaks are zero or set the maximum number of doses. Other options include simply setting the number of repeats of your choice or to repeat until peaks match the first peak. Inserting the start repeat step will also automatically insert the stop repeat step. To set the steps to dose until saturation, insert dose step in between start repeat and stop repeat steps. Temperature ramp can be inserted to either ramp up or cool down the temperature. Usually, ramp type is set as sample ramp to ramp the sample temperature to the end temperature. The furnace temperature is adjusted to meet this target. Enter the end temperature, ramp rate, and hold time of your choice. When cooling, check Enable Quick Cool if a quick cool is connected to the instrument. Uncheck if a cryo cooler is used. When Return to Ambient Ramp Type is selected, the furnace temperature is rapidly cooled down below 45 Celsius. Sample Ramp and Equilibrate ramps the sample temperature to the end temperature and waits for it to equilibrate before proceeding. Vapor calibration is used to make a calibration curve for a vapor from the vapor source. Select inert gas for carrier and loop. Set the desired reflux temperature range. Set the flask temperature range 5 degrees Celsius above the reflux temperature range and enter the number of steps. The wait step will wait for a specific time or have the instrument wait for the operator. This will suspend the analysis until the operator clicks OK to continue. This is useful if a cold trap needs to be installed in the middle of the analysis. Wait until baseline is stable should always be inserted before start recording step. Other available wait options include wait for change from the baseline or a user-specified number of minutes, wait for return to baseline, and wait for digital input number. In the termination step, zones can be set back to default if any changes were made during analysis. Ensure nothing is selected under output and return to ambient temperature is selected. If using Quick Cool, check Enable Quick Cool. If using Cryo Cooler, uncheck Enable Quick Cool. Several hours may be required for the analyzer to reach thermal stability after the detector is enabled. This option keeps the detector enabled after analysis, allowing the analyzer to remain stable. Gas flow through the detector is required when the detector is enabled, but it is not necessary if the detector is disabled. It is recommended to flow an inert gas to continuously purge the system. If a mass spectrometer is connected, the carrier gas is required to be on after the analysis until the mass spectrometer filament is manually turned off. Now you are ready to customize a sample on the Micromeritix AutoChem II Microactive software. For more information, visit micromeritix.com/learn.